They are the elite few, the generals and admirals who rose to the highest ranks of the military.
I will do my utmost to serve.
But the shine is off the stars, and it goes beyond retired General David Petraeus.
I can think of no better role, no more noble task.
The Defense Secretary just demoted four-star General Kip Ward and ordered him to repay the government over $80,000. Investigators found he used his rank to shuttle his wife on shopping sprees, enjoyed a lavish beachfront trip, and once accepted a defense contractor's gift of going backstage to meet Denzel Washington.
We're going to roll it, okay?
What do you mean roll it?
We got to do something to stop this guy. Here we go.
Brigadier General Jeffrey Sinclair is now being court-martialed for sodomy and other sex crimes at Fort Bragg. The military says when subordinates called him out on his attitude towards women, he allegedly said, quote, I'm a general. I'll do whatever the bleep I want. It makes General Stan McChrystal's comments about his bosses pale in comparison. Words in Rolling Stone that cost him his job in 2010.
The problem is that there's a cascade of these right now.
Retired General Spider Mark says, as an officer moves through the ranks, there are mechanisms in place that reinforce the military's values. But at the top, a lot of those checks and balances have fallen by the wayside, isolating the flag officer.
It's a thing called hubris. I mean, you know, at some point you think the rules just simply don't apply to you.
Military experts say that sense of entitlement sets a dangerous precedent for younger troops.
If we have a military that doesn't have a firm basis in understanding how important moral, ethical behavior and decision-making are to their daily actions and in terms of leadership, then that's that kind of puts everything in question.
These are truly aberrations.
Despite the lapses of judgment, Spider Marks believes military culture is still sound.
Look at the hundreds, the thousands of very senior officers at multiple levels who have served with incredible dignity.
Yeah, without a doubt, that is true. There are 1.4 million troops, but flag officers, fewer than 950. So generals and admirals make up the tiniest of tiny fractions of the military. So when you see 5, 6, 7 showing bad judgment, that's actually a larger percentage than you might initially think, Wolf.
Chris Lawrence, thanks very much. Let's